Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Wasatch. I'm your public relations officer, Roxy Goodwin.
And I'm Jameson Pace, one of your 7th grade reps.
Thanks to everyone who wore their red, white, and blue yesterday and joined us for lunchtime coloring. It was a lot of fun.
Today is winter holiday day. We hope you wore your ugly sweaters and are ready for our ugly sweater contest. We will be judging sweaters at lunch today.
Tomorrow is St. Patrick's Day, so don't forget to wear your green.
This week is Red Ribbon Week. Here is a video talking about Red Ribbon Week.
Don't forget there are tennis practices after school for 8th graders on Mondays and Wednesdays. Contact Mrs. Sulier if you are interested at jsulier@graniteschools.org.
There is a story, usually attributed to the Native American tradition, which illuminates different ways of paying attention. An elder, talking to a child, says, "I have two wolves fighting in my heart. One wolf is fearful, vengeful, envious, resentful, and deceitful. The other wolf is compassionate, loving, generous, truthful, and peaceful." The child asks, "Which wolf will win the fight?" The elder responds, "The one I feed." That doesn't mean we try to deny or hurt or kill the angry wolf. If we did that, we'd end up in a long battle, all the while somehow making that wolf more powerful through our hostility and fear. Hating that wolf sucks the strength right out of us. Instead, we calmly pay attention to the angry wolf and let go of believing they have the answers. If we can do that, they end up lying down next to us, no longer an enemy. We help strengthen the kind and loving wolf, giving it nourishment and support so that we can follow it. That peaceful wolf can become our steady companion and show us the way through all kinds of different life experiences. Restful or chaotic, enjoyable or disappointing experiences may come and go, but we can have a guide with us through it all. This is what mindfulness can help you do. Mindfulness allows us to see our thoughts and feelings as they are beginning. It's very powerful to know what we're feeling as we're feeling it, know what we're thinking as we're thinking it. With mindfulness, we can choose what will strengthen and bring into action, and we can choose what we will gently let go of. We don't have to be at the mercy of old habits or old ways of thinking or old ways of being. We are empowered. It just takes practice.
Have a tubular Tuesday, Wasatch.
creepy, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary.